QE flag is enabled in debug settings on your PlayStation 3. This is an official procedure used in service centers. However, to ease it, you have to use some hacker utilities that write changes to flash memory, which is always risky. So, be careful. First of all, you'll need a QE-enabled firmware with jailbreak patches. Most 3.55 custom firmware fit into this category. However, custom firmware of higher version doesn't necessarily support QE flag, so make sure you use a custom firmware which does. Now download Toggle QE PKG. The official utility site gives broken links, but Google is your friend. Install the package. Please note that this is a toggle, meaning first run will switch QE flag on, the next run will switch off, and so on. Successful run is indicated by the console beeping and returning to XMB. If it doesn't beep and doesn't return to XMB for longer than 30 seconds, don't worry. Just unplug the power cable, then plug it back and try again. When QE flag is toggled on, you have to go to the settings menu, then browse for and stand on network settings without actually going into them. Now press and hold, one by one, the following buttons: L1, L2, R1, R2, L3, and down on the D-pad. The settings list will expand for 3 more items. You have to run Toggle QE only once, however, to access the additional menu, you have to patch the button combo after each reboot. The debug settings are saved like any normal settings, so you don't have to set them back after reboot. I had a particular goal for QE flagging my PS3, and that is to check whether forcing 3D on in debug settings will allow me to fix some issues with 3D output to multiple displays, and it did.